Before seeing very interesting table in which we have once in the Torah Pesach Mashiach on Passover Messiah once in the Torah, and then we have also the date of this year Tafshin Einchet 5778, which is this year, as we said many times, from the creation of man. What we have now 5779 is from the creation of God, but the man who is the root of Messiah, as we know, the Messiah is the reincarnation of Adam, Adam, David, Messiah, abbreviation. So definitely should look at this day. So amazing, best meeting from definitely Pesach Messiah with this one. Now what you have here, it is interesting, you have Esther here. The question Esther, what she had to do with Passover, as we saw in the other table, connection between Purim and Passover. So we said simple, as it explains it, Purim is a time of hidden miracles. Yeah, we saw clearly the hidden miracle. And Nisan, Passover, is Nisin, clear miracles. So really the process starts from Purim, hidden one. Esther is really hidden, Aleph Seter, Aleph Esther, it is really hidden miracles. And then comes the open one, the revealed one, Nisan. But there is amazing another connection between Esther, the Queen Esther, to do this Pesach. Because there is a custom, as we just knew, which is very, very interesting, which our rabbi said, that Aman was hanged on the 16th of Nisan. I mean, one day after Passover, he was hung. Definitely there are clear proofs for it, yeah. Now, there is a custom. It is called the meal of Esther. This is the name, addition of food in the meal, which is to remember the feast of the second day of Passover, which was celebrated by some of the Ashkenazis in honor of the banquet that brought the hanging of Haman. Haman was hung the day after Passover. This was a banquet that Esther did, and this is called the banquet of Esther. It's a custom, really, of some to add to the meal on the second day of Passover. So, interesting connection, you know, between Esther in the scroll of Esther, the story of Purim, definitely, which brought the great salvation of Jews, and the hanging of Haman was on Pesach. So, a clear connection between Purim and Pesach, which falls on the other table. As we say, explain also the simple explanation, because Purim is a hidden, and Passover is a clear one, the revealed one, and also 30 days before, it is a known halacha, even so the 30 days before a festival already, one should prepare himself by studying the laws, to prepare himself for the coming festival. So I think from Purim is a clear process. Preparing ourselves for Passover. So let us really hope that on Passover we have the redemption. But let us see really what the table teaches us, which is very, very interesting. Because once in the Torah we have Pesach in red, you can see Pesach Mashiach on Passover Messiah. When in Pesach Tafshin, it's in black, Tafshin Ayin Chet, 5778, this year from the creation of Adam. And interesting is that you have parallel Elijah, yeah, Elijah, because Elijah is definitely coming as Messiah on Passover, Pesach, and also he was involved in Purim, very known story. He brought the information from up to down. So, and parallel is significant. You cannot make what he wants to. Once he comes parallel to Messiah, means a connection. As I said always, this program that I'm using is a program that was built by Dr. Rotenberg, Maurice Rotenberg. He is a scientist which became Orthodox Jews keeping everything, Shabbos and everything. When he saw the phenomena of the code, which is a clear proof that Torah from heaven, the fifth version is the five books of Moses, which was a blueprint of creation. It is known as the Kabbalah says, the Zohar says, the Reshit Bara is the Torah, which is called Reshit. So amazingly, this is what is the program which we found, and all what we discover now are through these tables. So what more behavior, very interesting, so beside having Esther with Messiah, by the way, the Vilna Gaon says that Esther is as a spark of myself, a son of Joseph. Anybody who have Israel is to do with the son of Yosef. And here you have really Yosef, is Rachel also, but then Yosef with the same line of Messiah, like Messiah, which have to do with Yosef, interesting. And then, what is so interesting, that we have more indication to Purim. We have Mordechai, here, who worked with Esther together, who brought Jews to repent and to, by this, to be safe from the terrible danger, threat of Holocaust. It was exactly, I said many times, that the story with Hitler and Haman, exactly the same thing, like Hitler came from nothing and in 8-9 years really managed to destroy 6 of the Jewish people, right? And terrible disaster. The same thing with Haman wanted. He wanted also the same thing. He came from nothing. Some say it was the slave of Mordechai even. And then he managed to make a decree of Holocaust, destroy, wipe out Jews. Well, because they listened to Esther and Mordechai, and they accepted what they said. They told them, you are in danger of Holocaust, you have to repent to keep the Torah. And they did it and they were saved. And Purim turned to be very, very festival, very happy festival for Jews. The Holocaust, rabbis told them the same thing. You know, if you read, I did a book about the Holocaust in Torah code, Bible code, with Professor Aralik. It's called The Holocaust in Bible code. And then you find clearly that the rabbis told Jews it's going to be Holocaust if you are carrying on translating the Torah, this against the Shabbos, and especially against the Reform. You know, this was the rabbi said, the Reform who started to cut off, take off laws from the Torah to make their own code of law. So this was said, the rabbi Misalant, the rabbi said to them, you Jewish now, Reform, you start a new code of law, the Torah, so Nuremberg, you know, Hitler will start with the new code against Jews. You see exactly what happened. So it's amazing to see how much faith and belief we can see from all these things. Now, as I said, you have your Megillah, minimum the Torah, with Esther definitely, Mordechai and Purim you have here, also Purim all over. Interesting, the connection. Hidden redemption, clear one, revealed one will come. Now, what is the most interesting, that even we don't find here the word Teshuva, repentance, but there is another important condition that our rabbis tell us that we need in order to be redeemed. This is faith, belief in God. And this is what you hear here, ha-emuna, you can see it, ha-emuna. The faith, this was Jews have in Purim, they had a strong belief in Esther and Mordechai, in God, and this turned to be really a God brought to this great happiness and joy of Purim, you know, the great happiness. Now we have another time, here Mordechai, and also ha-emuna, also faith. Twice faith. Now, Rabbi said something interesting. Tivot Shalom said, and the great Rabbi said, that there are different kind of faith. There is an intellectual one. Yeah, you see the things are going, you understand with your mind, but it's not enough. It should be another one. It should be emotion in the heart. Even should be also practical. But there are two kinds. So this is exactly what he saw also when Jews came out in Egypt. Twice they believed and again they believed, because in the beginning, it was like perhaps intellectually understood, yeah, but to feel it inside, to feel in the heart, emotionally, there is a God, then this is another God. And this is what we had in Purim. In Purim, Jews really came to these things, to emunah, emunah, twice, amazing. This is why it comes again. Now, by the way, have you Amalekite? Because Amalekite also a man. Not the story of Haman, yeah, definitely, this is a was the Amen at that time. Now what is interesting is that if you go a little bit higher here, you have the Hebrew word Haman Talui. Haman is hung. Yeah, hung. Amazing. With Mashiach together come Mashiach. But if it is higher than the table you can see, which we can see. But nevertheless interesting, you know, that indications it was hung very high, and it is not the story. So, interesting table, significant table, and really hoping that people don't understand, because I see that people don't understand exactly Purim, Pesach, connection, definitely, if we are lacking the knowledge, and, you know, what is written about it. I don't know how many knew that the Feast of Esther, which brought then to Haman was really in the second of Percival. So interesting and important, significant table, hoping really that this Purim already will be a start of redemption, of Mashiach will be finished and clear, and great miracles on Passover.